Hi students, in the last video we have discussed about the constitution, meaning of constitution, about the constituent assembly, the drafting committee and the preamble. Now we will be moving ahead and discussing the silent features of the constitution. Silent features of the constitution drawn from different sources. From British constitution we have borrowed the parliamentary form of government, the rule of law, lawmaking procedure. From the United States Constitution, we have borrowed the fundamental rights, power of judicial review. From Irish Constitution, we have borrowed directive principles of state policy. From the French Constitution, we borrowed the principles of liberty, equality and fraternity. From Canadian Constitution, we borrowed federal form of government and residual power. Second feature is written and the lengthiest constitution. Our constitution is written and the lengthiest, comprising of 395 articles and 12 schedules, partially rigid and partially flexible. The third feature, our constitution has struck a sound balance between a rigidity and flexibility. It's not only so flexible like the British constitution, nor it is too rigid like the American constitution. The fourth feature, that is the federal system. We have a government which is federal in form and unitary in spirit. Federal, as the constitution provides for the division of power between the center and the state, while unitary as the center is more powerful. Now, fifth, parliamentary form of government. We have a parliamentary form of government which provides for an elected president who is a nominal head of the Indian Union. Sixth point, that is secularism. India is a secular state where people are free to follow the religion of their choice. Seventh, fundamental duties, rights and directive principles. The framers of our constitution have included the directive principles to promote the welfare of the people and have given basic rights to people as fundamental rights. India is sovereign democratic republic. Now we will discuss the eighth feature, that is independence of judiciary. The judiciary has been separated from the executive and the legislature to protect the people's fundamental right. Now it's time for to discuss the ninth feature, that is universal adult franchise. Voting right for all people over the age of 18 is mean universal adult franchise. Now the last and the 10th feature, that is single citizenship. Now what is single citizenship? We have single citizenship though we are federation of states. Our constitution provides adequate measures for the protection of the weaker and minority sections of the society. Now here comes an end of this chapter. Now I want to request my students to go through these questions, take a pause in your videos and write these important questions and try to solve them at your home. First, what is constitution? Second, what is the purpose of our preamble? Third, why should we follow the fundamental duties? Fourth, describe in brief how our constitution came into existence. Fifth, why do we need to make amendments in our constitution? Then six, what objectives were kept in mind before preamble was drafted? I hope you